From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
You're watching News 8 Now. I'm Shannon Moss.
And I'm Erin O'Valley. In case you haven't noticed, heavy rain expected today.
And with all the snow that we've had, that has many people living along Maine's rivers starting to think about the possibility of flooding, especially in Hollowell by the Kennebec River. As they say, but Ponton has more for us.
Here in Hollowell, along the banks of the Kennebec River, people who work in these businesses and live along the river are getting ready for what could be potential flooding. We spoke with the business owner here from the Wharf Restaurant, and she says that they've got boxes ready to go in case they need to pick up and evacuate. Law enforcement officials are also warning people who park in low-lying areas that they should move their cars in case the river does overflow its banks. And again, the businesses here, which of course, no stranger to flooding, people who live here. In fact, some of the buildings here in town have watermarks from previous years to show how high the water has gotten. Hopefully it does not reach those stages today or tomorrow. We will keep an eye on things and keep you updated as how they progress and what you need to know. For now, from Hollowell along the banks of the Kennebec River, I'm Tamil Ponton, News 8 Now.
A man from Livermore Falls facing a charge of arson is expected to enter a plea in court today. Authorities say 36-year-old Violette Senhier set fire to the treasure chest in Livermore Falls last month. The fire started near the front door of the thrift store on Depot Road. Violette also faces a charge of violating probation. That's because he's on probation for a previous arson conviction back in 2003. And take a look here. This woman, Carol Swan, is also expected to be in court today. Swan, the chairperson of the Board of Selectmen in the town of Chelsea, faces criminal charges involving town funds. Last month, police arrested her on charges of aggravated forgery, two counts of improper compensation for services, as well as attempted theft. Today's hearing focuses on Swan's bail conditions. She wants the judge to lift the restriction barring her from town hall. A man accused of running a scam at a bottle redemption center in Kittery could enter a plea in court today. Police say Thomas and Megan Woodward stole more than $10,000 by redeeming no deposit containers from New Hampshire and Massachusetts right here in Maine. Investigators say Thomas and Megan operate Green Bee Redemption on Old Post Road. Megan is also facing charges in this case.
Two bills that would change the minimum wage here in Maine will be at the center of a public hearing in Augusta today. Now, one would increase the minimum wage to $7.75 per hour starting October 1st, 2011, then to $8 per hour on October 1st, 2012, a year later. Other would adjust the minimum wage for the rate of inflation on October 1st of each year. Right now, the minimum wage is $7.50. Well, men from the Serenity House, a residential treatment facility for substance abuse, will be in Augusta to speak at this morning's hearing on the state budget. Maine Office of Substance Abuse recently notified several state programs that their funding would be cut if Governor Paul LePage's budget passes as is. Well, Serenity House, which has been open now for more than 40 years, says that would force them to close. State Representative Ben Chipman is running a van for those men.
And thanks for tuning into this News 8 Now update. I'm Erin O'Valley.
And I'm Shannon Moss. Stay with us. We're going to bring the latest forecasts and sports highlights in just a few minutes. We'll be right back.